So we will start with the second chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants include three main events. These three main events are pre-fertilization events, then fertilization, and then post-fertilization events. In pre-fertilization events, again there are two processes, and these two processes are gametogenesis process and gamete transfer. Now, gametogenesis means the formation of male and female gametes within one flower or within two flowers. It depends all upon the type of flower, whether it is a unisexual flower or it is a bisexual flower. Now, gametogenesis means the formation of male gamete, that is microsporogenesis, and the formation of female gamete, that is megasporogenesis process. And we have already discussed about microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis. So now we will go through the second topic of this having, that is pre-fertilization events, that is gamete transfer. How the gametes are transferred in the case of flowers? There is a proper process which is known as pollination. Pollination means the transfer of pollen grains from the anther of a flower to the stigma of a flower. Now, pollination is again categorized into different categories. It may be self-pollination or cross-pollination. Self-pollination is also known as autogamy, and cross-pollination is also known as allogamy or xenogamy. But it all depends on the type of flower. See, pollination can be categorized into three categories basically. These three categories are, number one, autogamy. Autogamy means the transfer of pollen grain within a same flower. That means the stigma of the same flower, it occurs always in a bisexual flower. The same flower receives the pollen grains. Then, second one is gametogamy. Gametogamy, it means the transfer of pollen grains between the two different flowers of a same plant. One flower is having pollen grains, it spreads its pollen grains, and the second flower of the same plant, it receives the pollen grain of its own kind. This is known as gametogamy. Then the third one is allogamy. It is also known as xenogamy. Xenogamy or allogamy means cross-pollination, pure cross-pollination, in which the pollen grains of one flower transfers to the flower of another plant. That means this process occurs between the two different plants. Autogamy occurs in a single flower, gametogamy occurs between the two flowers of a same plant, and xenogamy occurs between the two flowers of two different plants. Now, those plants which promotes self-pollination, they have proper characteristics, or these characteristics are called homogamy and cleistogamy. Now, what is homogamy and cleistogamy? Homogamy means when the anthers and the stigma, they get ripe, they get mature at the same time. This promotes the self-pollination in bisexual flowers. And if it is second one, that is cleistogamy. Cleistogamy means the type of flowers which do not open properly, which remain closed. They are bisexual flowers, they have both the sex organs, they have stamen, they have stigma, but these remain inside the petals. And the pollen grains get transferred to its own stigma within the flower only. The reproductive parts of these flowers do not expose themselves. वो अपने आप को expose नहीं करते कि दूसरे किसी flower का pollen grain आके उनके stigma पे land कर जाए. So these are the characteristics of autogamy. Then xenogamy. There are some characteristics of xenogamy also. These characteristics include chasmogamous flower. they are totally open flowers, as you would have seen the rose flower, as you would have seen the China rose, hibiscus. The sex organs of these flowers are exposed and they are ready to receive the pollen grains from the other plants or other flowers. Then there is dichogamy. Dichogamy means the maturation time of stigma and anther are different, total different. It can be categorized as protandry or protogyny. Protogyny is the condition when the stigma gets matured earlier to the stamen, and protandry is the condition when the stamens get matured before the pollination. Then another one is self-sterility. Self-sterility, or you can call it as incompatibility. Incompatibility means that when the pollens of some other plants, जो एक दूसरे में आपस में उनकी पहचान होती है, हम कह सकते हैं, because there are chemicals on the stigma also, there are chemicals which are present in internal exine of the pollen also. So there is a compatibility, एक दूसरे को पहचानने की उनके अंदर क्षमता होती है. If they are of right type, then their stigma receives the pollen grain and the pollen tube germinates. Sometimes what happens that these kind of flowers which are bisexual, just to avoid that self-pollination, they do not receive, they do not accept their own pollen grain. This is known as self-sterility or incompatibility. Then another thing, the flowers are unisexual. They are made unisexual by nature so that there should be cross-pollination, there should be variation, there should be evolution through this. Through sexual reproduction.